Hello, so in this video I'm going to discuss an elementary idea of CFS. In my last videos I've discussed about the postulates of CFT, even I've given a discussion on the orientation of the orbitals, which is an basic for the this particular topic, that is the topic which I'm going to discuss here, that is the crystal field splitting. Crystal field splitting is an a special phenomenon which occurs in transition metal complexes only. It is an special phenomenon by which it is possible to explain the color nature of the metal complexes. So right now I'm going to discuss about an elementary idea of the CFS. So you know about the d subshell is having five important d orbitals, that is dxy, yz, xz, dx square minus y square and dz square. So usually in any subshell, if you take any kind of subshell, the orbitals, whatever may be the number of orbitals, they will be having a degeneracy. They maintain the degeneracy. What is the meaning of degeneracy? Degeneracy means all the orbitals present in the subshell will have an equal energy. Will have an equal energy, and that is called as the degeneracy. So even in the d subshell also, as 5 d orbitals are present, they will be degenerating in nature. Now consider a hypothetical case in which the set of 5 d orbitals of metal ion is spherically surrounded by uniformly spread negative charges. Negative charges means, you know, it is nothing but the ligand. Now the electrostatic repulsion between the d electrons and set positive charge means it is here metal ion. We already said here, not we, like CFT says that the interaction between the metal ion and the ligand is just interaction between like two oppositively charged substances or particles, it is electrostatic in nature. So positive charge would result in uniform increasing in the energies of the d orbitals. Now what happens is, if when a metal ion is surrounded by a ligand, if anybody unknown to you is surrounds you, then obviously that anxiety, then that will be an increasing in your energy level. Meanwhile, the same thing happens here. When an unknown ligand is surrounding the metal ion, the energy of the electrons of the d orbitals, now it is go on increasing. And now what happens, the orbitals, even though there is an increasing in the energy of the orbitals, all the orbitals acquire higher energy equally. I mean to say that now, even though they occupy or they accommodate at the higher energy, or they have an higher energy, this will still remain degenerately. 5 d orbitals will remain constantly. There is no splitting as such, because all are equally surrounded. The negative charges spread surrounding the metal ion equally, spherically, as there is no inequality in the energy, raising the energy. Now what happens, the degeneracy is maintained. And now you consider that the negative charges surrounding the d orbitals of the metal ion, it gets concentrated in a number of point charges in a specific position, and the now case differs. Because in the previous cases, the positive charges, that means the ligand, were surrounded equally, were surrounded spherically, and now the case is different, that the negative charges are accommodating in certain positions, certain corners of the complexes. Now what happens, the orbitals which are directed in the direction of that particular negative charges will attain the higher energy, and now the degeneracy is broken. Now the degeneracy is now broken, because the orbitals which are specifically directing in that way will have a greater energy than those of orbitals which are not orienting in that particular direction. Obviously now what happens, 5d orbitals having a degeneracy will break up, and now the 5 degenerate d orbitals will split up into two, that is as T2g and Eg. I already mentioned in my last video, T2g, Eg, this differentiation is mainly because of the orientation of those orbitals in the coordinate axis, in the coordinate space. You may ask, why it is not possible that the dxy, x square minus y square, dz square can be 1? No, it is not possible, because this differentiation mainly because of the orientation of those orbitals in the coordinate space, and these T2G, what we consider T2G, these three orbital, T2G includes DXY, YZ, XZ, these are orienting between the coordinate axes, whereas DX square minus Y square, DZ square are orienting along the axis. And since these positive charges accommodate in certain position, now the degeneracy is lost and this will split up into two set of orbital, that is as T2G and EG. And this particular phenomenon, that is the splitting up of 5 degenerate d orbitals into two set of orbital having unequal energy, is called as crystal field splitting. And this is the reason why colored nature of the complexes, of transition complexes exist. Even your low spin, high spin concepts, even your inner orbital and outer orbital complexes, this is mainly because of this particular reason, that is a crystal field splitting. I don't say that once the crystal field splitting takes place, only EG will acquire the higher energy, T2G will acquire the higher lower energy, or T2G acquires the higher energy and EG acquires the higher energy. That occupying or that gaining of higher energy or downing of the energy, that mainly depends on the way through which the ligand is approaching the central metal ion, and that also depends on the geometry of the complexes. In mainly in case of the octahedral complexes, the ligand approaches along the axis. In case of square planar complexes, sometimes the way may be near to the orbitals which are orienting between the coordinate axes, as such. Sometimes it may be along the axis, sometimes it may be between the coordinate axis, and this plays an important role where energy gaining of the orbitals and the downing of the orbitals. And here I shows the picture, that is here, that is a free metal ionic state where metal without the ligand, and this is the case where exactly the metal ion is surrounded by the spherically by the ligands, and there is no lossing of the degeneracy, and degeneracy is maintained, and this shows the splitting of d orbitals in octahedral crystal field. You can take any one, but exactly I have taken here octahedral crystal field. Why? Because here also we can specify the negative charges accommodating at the particular position. And this picture will give you a detailed knowledge about the crystal field splitting, an elementary idea. And crystal fielding splitting, as I mentioned earlier, they differ from geometry, that varies according to geometry. So the crystal field splitting was nothing but splitting of 5 degenerate d orbitals of the metal into two set of orbitals having different energy is called as crystal field splitting. So here I conclude my video. This video was about the elementary idea. I have not specified here the which geometry I should talk in, and in my next videos, in frequent videos, I'm going to discuss the crystal field splitting in octahedral and in tetrahedral and square planar complexes. I end up here. Thank you.